You have to love dancing to stick to it. It gives you nothing back. No manuscripts to store away. No paintings to show on walls and maybe hang in museums. No poems to be printed and sold. Nothing but that single fleeting moment when you feel alive. Merce Cunningham.
Bharathanatyam, the search for our own divinity.
In the city of Chidambaram, which means clothed in thought, in the ancient Indian language of Sanskrit, in South India, exists one of the oldest living temple complexes in the world, having been built in the 10th century by the Chola kings. This temple pays homage to the ancient notion in Indian thought that the divine is completely accessible through the arts. It is the home of Nataraja, who is Lord Shiva in his dancing form. In the grand columns of Chidambaram exist the most exquisite carvings of all the 108 karanas or dance movements as listed in the Natya Shastra. The Natya Shastra is a text from 200 BC that is comprised of 36 chapters and 6,000 poetic verses that lay the foundation for the exquisite dance form of Bharatanatyam.
Ba, which is short for bhavam or emotional expression. Ra, standing for raga or melody. Da, denoting thalam or rhythmic patterns. And natyam, which is a dramatization of theme, all make up the beautiful dance that is Bharatanatyam. From the karanas found in the statues of Chidambaram emerge the basic units of Bharatanatyam, known as the adavas. There are usually 70 to 80 adavas in practice today, although the ancient texts list about 120.
In addition to the basic adavas, Bharatanatyam utilizes a vocabulary of hand gestures known as the mudras. There exists about 28 single-handed gestures and 24 double-handed gestures that can be used to convey various actions in a performance. Mudras are used to convey a wide range of actions in telling a tale. In addition to the intricate footwork and hand gestures, the facial expressions and eyes convey a wealth of information in a Bharatanatyam performance.
According to Natya Shastra, drama is that art which accepts that human beings are in different inner states when they arrive as audience. It is then, through the art performed, that they take away from it what they can. The purpose of Bharatanatyam, therefore, is to present truths about life through emotions and circumstances, using the vast repertoire of classical literature, mythology, and tales that put forth questions of ethics or dharma. While the immediate purpose of this dance is to deliver entertainment, its real purpose is to abet in the very human quest for self-discovery that should lead to a state of higher consciousness. When dancing in a rhythm, a human body is supposed to be rid of its weakness and become a conduit for something larger. This experience can be total only when a variety of moods and feelings are portrayed and felt.
This is achieved in Bharatanatyam through the use of expressive devices to create what is known as the rasas or emotional states.
Happiness, sorrow, love, contempt, anger, fear, surprise, thoughtfulness.
These Devadasi families specialized in the arts of music and dance and maintained these traditions from generation to generation, supported by royal patronage.
Bharatanatyam has been practiced for centuries in the temples of South India. What we know as Bharatanatyam today springs from Sadiranatyam, or Sadir. This dance was patronized in the royal courts of the Maratha rulers of Tanjore, and it evolved outside the courts in the temples as well. A Devadasi, or servant of God, was an artist who was dedicated to the services of the temple. The dance of the Devadasi was integral to the ritual worship. These Devadasi families specialized in the art of music and dance, and maintain these traditions from generation to generation, supported by royal patronage.
An important milestone in this evolution was the development of the current format of the Bharatanatyam recital, the Margam. This happened in the late 18th century at the hands of four brothers known as the Tanjavur Quartet, who also worked to refine the music of Bharatanatyam, influenced by their mentor, the great composer Muthuswami Dikshitar.
Elements shaped Sadar into the precursor of what we call Bharatanatyam today. However, we almost lost it all. Under British rule, propaganda prevailed against Indian art, misrepresenting it as crude, immoral, and inferior to the concepts of Western civilization.
This propaganda attacked the Devadasis and was pervasive enough to dissuade their patronage of royal courts and to alienate educated Indians from their traditions. The Devadasi system declined. Most of the women were forced to seek the patronage of ordinary wealthy people, which led to social exploitation. This, in turn, led to a diminishing of its reputation. Even the terms by which the dance was known as Sadir, Nach, Dasiyattam, and so on, took on derogatory connotations. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, an anti-Nach campaign was launched to eradicate the art, condemning it as a social evil. By the first quarter of the 20th century, the classical dance of South India was almost wiped out.
Against all odds, a few families preserved the knowledge of this dance tradition and fought for its revival. The ranks included Indian freedom fighters, Westerners interested in Indian arts, people outside the Devadasi class who learned Bharatanatyam, and the Devadasis themselves. Bharatanatyam slowly started to attract young artists from respectable families. Initially met with shock, their participation ultimately helped to shift public opinion in favor of reviving the art. One such artist was Rukmini Devi.
Rukmini Devi had trained under a pupil of the great ballerina Anna Pavlova. Anna was an intellectual who had studied Indian spiritual and artistic thought. When Anna herself was approached by Rukmini to be her teacher, the great ballerina advised her to learn classical Indian dance instead, gently nudging Rukmini to reconsider her roots. Rukmini was fortunate to be married into a theosophical society, family with progressive views, and her husband George Arundel supported her efforts with rigor. Rukmini Devi's unique background from the respectable ranks of society equipped her to revive the existing Bharatanatyam to emphasize its spirituality. She went on to found Kalakshetra, and her reforms of costume, stage setting, repertoire, musical accompaniment, and thematic content overcame the many objections of conservatives. An association of Devadasis joined this effort to revive Bharatanatyam, including the family of the legendary dancer Bala Saraswati. Bala Saraswati promoted the traditional art of the Devadasis, maintaining that reforms were unnecessary and detracted from the art.
But no matter the differences, the renewed awareness of Bharatanatyam in Indian society allowed many Natuvanads to resume their training activities and many artists to enter the field of classical dance. Rukmini Devi's desire to restore the full spiritual potential of the dance was slowly achieved by the mid-20th century. Today, Bharatanatyam is hailed as one of India's greatest cultural treasures. Bharatanatyam, with a long and impressive history and meticulous artistic sensibilities, it is an art form that has a capacity to entertain and delight the senses. However, for a true practitioner and viewer, it transcends the ordinary, swelling up like the boundless ocean, taking us on an irresistible search, a quest, an adventure.
A journey where we seek our own divinity.